Good evening. Tonight, I wanted to show you one of my favorite board games. This game is really good. Nice, quick game. It is for two players. So I'm going to set this up, and then we'll talk about how to play. All right. We'll take the board out first. The board for original Patchwork is two-sided. You can choose either side. Both of them are the same. I personally like this side quite a bit. So I think we'll do a little demo with this one. All right. it is kind of set up a little bit here. So as you are setting up, each player takes a quilt board. You can choose between yellow and green. And then you will also take the corresponding time token. You will then take 5 buttons. You'll want to keep the remaining buttons close at hand as you're purchasing and gaining buttons throughout the game. You will then place the central game board in the middle of your playing space. You will then place your time tokens on the starting space. For this side, it is the long red rectangle. You can choose whoever wants to go first, but officially, it would be the last person that used a needle. You will then place all of your regular patches along the outside of your playing board. I did not place all of them in this example because my space is limited, but your circle will be quite. You will then locate the smallest patch, which is this one, a 1x2. You will place the neutral token between the smallest and the next piece. You will be moving the neutral token as you purchase patches clockwise. You also have one special token. It is a 7x7. This token is given to the player that is able to complete a 7x7 square on their playing board. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So you're looking at filling this entire space with patches. You will then want to place the special patches on the board as indicated. Now you are set up and ready to play. In this game, you do not necessarily alternate between turns. The player whose token is the farthest behind on the time board will take their turn. This may result in a player taking more than one turn. If both tokens are on the same place, the player whose token is on the top goes first. So on your turn, you can take one of two actions. You can advance and receive buttons, or you can take and place a patch. To advance and receive buttons, you are going to move as many spaces as it takes to get in front of the other player. So if I were the yellow, I would go 1, 2, 3, and I would receive 3 buttons. The next action you could take is to take and place a patch. You will first choose the patch. You can choose from any 3 patches in front of the neutral token. 1, 2, 3. You will move the neutral token. If I chose this patch, I would then move my neutral token to the hole left by the patch. So the next turn, the next 3 patches in front of the neutral token would be available. I then need to pay for my patch. There is a symbol that looks like a small button. I need to pay 3 for this patch. One, two, three. I would then be required to move 1 space, as indicated by the number next to the hourglass. Then I would place my patch. The patches themselves may not overlap, but you may turn your piece any which way you need it to be. Regardless of the action you take, you will always move your space forward, or move your token forward. You will either move forward the number of indicated space on your patch, or you will need to advance until you are in front of the other player. You will continue doing this until you all the way to the center. Along the way, you will notice on the board there are buttons and patches. Each time you pass a button, you will collect the number of buttons on your patches. If I had these on my board, I would collect 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 buttons each time I pass a blue button on the board. This number will likely grow as you continue and gain more patches on your board. You will also collect the special patch each time you pass one. These are single patches you can put anywhere on your board. The game ends once both tokens reach the center. In order to score, you will determine the number of buttons that you have left, adding the value of the special tile if you received it. And then you will subtract 2 points for each empty square on your quilt board. The player with the highest score wins. And that is how you play back.